I had just made a video about this. I was like 6 minutes in y se me borró todo. I don't know where it went. But anyways, les voy a contar otra vez. If you guys follow us on TikTok, YouTube, ustedes saben que nos corrieron en la Valley. One of the spot that I sell the most. Ahí es donde yo pago pues mis empleados, las deudas que tengo, inventario. I pay all of it, you know? Pues resulta que el dueño ha estado yendo ahí por la Valley Bloomington ya por varios días, corriendo toda la gente. Hasta he even brought a tractor one day because he wanted everyone to leave. I mean, a nosotros nos tocó que nos dijo, hey, you guys have to leave. Cuando yo escuché eso, hey, you guys have to leave, immediately what I did is, obviously, I don't want to be rude or anything. I moved to the other side. Me fui del otro lado, donde hay muchos más puestos. The only thing I don't like about that place is that it's muy difícil de encontrar parqueadero. People like can almost get into car crashes because it's just so small and there's like so many puestos. Last week cuando me dijeron, hey, ya no puedes estar ahí, like seriously, that whole week I was just very sad. I was like, I felt like defeated. If you guys saw my TikTok, I was like crying. Obviously, I didn't want to be disrespectful and keep putting myself there. And every time I would go by that, where we used to put ourselves, veía todos los puestos que todavía se seguían poniendo. And like, honestly, it will break my heart. Like, I would just feel like, go like anger or like sadness. It was just a bunch of feelings. Obviously, like, you know, like, how come they're not paying attention? How come they're not moving when the owner says he doesn't want anyone there? He even brought a tractor, lo estaba corriendo todo, pero cada día no les importaba y llegaban y se ponían ahí. They didn't even care what the freaking owner said. He even had to get a police report. I know now the reason why he was really pissed off is because people were not being responsible with their own trash. It came to the point where there was like sofas in there, there were sillones, couches, rocks, a bunch of trash, like so much trash. It looks so ugly, and that's why he wanted to, you know, to que los corriera todos, because eventually, after I spoke to him, eventually what the reason why he wanted everyone out is because they're gonna do construction in there. Esa semana I was like super sad, you know, I was just upset and everything. After I felt just defeated after eating pizza cupcakes, because when I'm sad I tend to eat a lot. After being sad in my room crying, I spoke to my sister's fiance. He's really good with business and stuff. My sister was telling him like, hey, you know, I really don't like seeing my sister sad because obviously I'm the boss, I'm the CEO. If I'm not there 100%, obviously like, the business doesn't run quite as we would like to. So my sister was really sad for me because she will see me that I will be in my room crying, and I will text my sister like, hey, can you please take care of downstairs, can you take care of the business just for these last couple of hours, because honestly I don't want to be downstairs, I don't want to look at anyone right now, and I just wanted to be sad, I just wanted to cry in my room sin que nadie se diera cuenta. Ellos me dieron, my sister, her fiance, me dieron la idea de que like, okay, the owner, he's pissed off, he's mad, why? Because there's a lot of trash. It's like, why don't you clean it? I was like, you know what? Like, even though he said no, the owner, he said, like, no one can be there. I'm gonna step up. I'm going to clean in there. So lo que hice, era el lunes, me acuerdo muy bien. Me levanté a las 11 de la mañana. Lo primero que hice, vi en Facebook Marketplace y vi que una persona estaba, I called that person, how much do you charge to clean this many, you know, acres of land that's just sofas in there, there's rocks, it looks ugly, there's trash bags everywhere. He gave me a quote, that was like $450, but the only thing is that I was like, okay, cool, I'm willing to pay that amount. But then he said, I can only do it on Tuesday, which was the next day. And for me, like, I wanted to do it as quick as possible. So I was like, okay, cool, I'll let you know. I went and called another person that I found on Facebook Marketplace. He gave me a quote, $430. The thing that I liked about him is that he was willing to do it that same day. An hour, like 2 hours more later than when I called him. Like around 2 o'clock. Yo le llamé como a las 11 y él vino ahí como a la 1 de la tarde. I told him I was gonna meet him in there. What is it exactly that I wanted? Get rid of all this. He gave me a quote, $430. I was like, awesome, you know, here's the money, just clean this whole place up, let me know when you're done. The guy, he called me, he was done, I was happy about it, it looks super clean. So what I did is like, okay, cool, so this place is clean. I know I had the person's phone number that took care of the property owner. I have his number, So I was like, okay, cool, I'm gonna call him real quick and let him know that I cleaned that place. I call him up and I was like, hey, I'm not gonna say the real names, obviously, to protect them. I was like, Ben, hey, my name is Erica. The reason why I have your phone number is because I know you've been coming a lot of times. You don't want anyone to be there anymore. And I got your number because on the police report, it said your phone number and your name. It's like, oh, okay, what can I help you in? I was like, yeah, just letting you know that, you know, I do want to apologize because, you know, we've been putting ourselves all the time, a lot of stands still there without your permission, and you've been telling them all the time that you don't want to be there. And I totally get that because it's trashed out. There's like a lot of trash, and I know you've been wanting to clean, but they don't let you because there's a lot of stands in there. I was like, just to let you know, I did clean the place. I hired someone so, you know, they can clean the whole place. And just letting you know that it's completely clean right now. And he stayed quiet for a little bit. And then he's all like, okay, well, I'm gonna head over there right now. I was like, cool, awesome. I head over there. I saw him. I introduced myself formally. And I told him, he's like, wow, I really like it how it came out. I was like, oh, yes, you know, they just cleaned it yesterday, so, you know. Just letting you know that it's totally clean. I wanted to offer you something if, you know, I'm willing to pay you on a monthly basis for me to put my stand in here just to sell. And then he's all like, you know what? I'm actually just the person that takes care of it, but I'm gonna contact the owner to see if she wants to. I was like, okay then. Is it okay if I give you a call back later today or maybe tomorrow? He's like, yeah, you could do that. I waited, obviously. I didn't hear nothing. And just to let you know, I had called this person, Ben, prior to me actually contacting him and him picking up the phone. It was like maybe 5 times. So I had tried to really get a hold of him. Anyway, so I was like waiting for his call. I didn't hear anything. The next day, I was like, okay, the next day I'm just gonna give him a call just to see, maybe he forgot, I don't know. I call him, he's like, hey, were you able to talk to the owner? Were you able to call Jane to see if she wants to do it? And he's all like, you know what? I haven't been able to get a hold of her. It's always sometimes hard to get a hold of her, but I'll let you know if I do hear from her. I was like, okay, cool. I didn't hear anything from the next day, I believe. And I think I waited until 2 days later. I didn't hear nothing from him. And then I call him again. It's like, hey, were you able to get a hold of her? And he's like, no, I haven't been able to. And then I was like, you know, is it okay if I have her phone number and I can give her a call and I can introduce myself and let her know, you know, what I have to offer? And then he's all like, you know what? Yeah, I can give it to you. You know, I mean, you clean the place and, you know, it's a great deal what you're offering. So why not? He gave me the phone number. I was like, thankful. Thank God. Immediately call her. I immediately called Jane and she didn't answer. I called like maybe 5 times. Nothing. I left her voicemails, text messages, nada. Until I think I got a hold of her the next day. I called her in the morning, like after the 6th time. I knew it was her phone number because like I checked. I was just being a psycho, like not a psycho, but I was being a creep. I went online, I searched for her first name and last name because, you know, he had already given me all that. I just wanted to know if it maybe was the wrong number or whatever. She's not answering, but no, it's the right person. So I call, I was like, okay, I'm gonna call her one more time. I did, and she answered, and I was like, hey, I was so nervous. Mis bolitas estaban como así. I was like this. Hey, you know, Jane, hi, my name is Erica. The reason why I have your phone number is because Ben, he gave me your phone number. I don't know if he told you, but I actually, I'm willing to rent out the place that you have between the street in Valley and Bloomington. And then she's all like, you know what, I'm not interested. I'm not willing to rent out that property. I was like, oh, okay. Well, okay. Well, if you ever change your mind, just, you know, just let me know you have my phone number. Like, okay, bye. She was like so cold. I felt like, I don't know. It was just like, it felt so cold. But anyways, I was so sad, and you know, I was like, fuck. That's when I made the TikTok. I was crying. I was like, fuck, I don't have no hope. I cleaned this place. Then I was sad again for the next like day or so. I ate even more. The next day, I spoke to my sister again. My sister, keep in mind, has been talking to her fiance, which is like a good business person. And then she gave me an idea. It's like, why are you stopping there? Like, call her again and let her know, like, the way you introduce yourself and you talked about yourself, like, I would say no too if I was her. I was like, fuck. So after a long conversation with my sister, I was like, you know what? I'm gonna give it one more try and I'm gonna give her a call the next day. Maybe she's in a better mood. Maybe she was just not having a good day. I don't know. I went out and I called, I didn't call her. I actually called Ben. I was like, hey Ben, just to let you know, he said no. I know you take care of different properties that she owns. No, she said no, and I just wanted to thank you. You're a very nice person, and I already know you. Just want to thank you because I know you tried to get me in contact with her, but I wanted to give you a deal. What if I clean the place for you, and I'll make sure that the place is completely clean, make sure that there's no trash, make sure that there's no people living in there, and just let me stay there. The only thing is that, you know, I cannot take responsibility for the other people that are selling in there. What I can do is I can let them know, it's like, I have your permission to be there to sell there, but only me. Because I can talk about me and my employees, we can clean the place up. What I'm willing to do is I'll make sure that nobody sells in there. Make sure that, you know, they don't ruin your property. Make sure everything's clean. If there's a sofa, beds, trash, I'm willing to take care of it. You don't even have to worry about it. I know you have sometimes a lot of stress because you take care of so many properties. So if you are willing to let me just take care of this property, you know, people are gonna still keep coming to sell in there and keep putting themselves, even though you say no. I mean, it requires someone to be there all the time to let people know that they cannot sell there, that they cannot be there. And obviously I can't offer you the money because, you know, it's not yours, but I can do this other thing of always keeping it clean and make sure that, you know, it's always 100%. Just take care of it like if it was my land. He's all like, you know what, like, I'm willing to give it a try, but I'm still gonna talk to the owner, to Jane, to see if she lets you. But for right now, we could do that. I was like, okay, well, you know, thank you so much. By that time, I was like on top of the world. I was like super happy because like now I had something where I can tell other people, like, hey, you guys cannot be here because they didn't care. Like these stands, they didn't care if it was trash. Like nobody did anything when there was like trashed out except me. I was so happy. I was telling people like, hey, you guys cannot be here. And then the next day, I decided, obviously, I made a deal with Ben that I was gonna keep the place clean. The next day, since that was my promise, what I did is after we stopped selling, I made sure that everything was completely clean. The person that was living there, he left. Obviously, he was no longer coming back. I took care of all that. I still got like one or two bags just worth of trash, even though it was just one day. And then after that, Jane came. She saw me cleaning the place. She told me, she's like, hey, are you the person that call me a bunch of times? I was like, yes, that's me. I was like scared. I was like, fuck, like, I know she said no, not to be here, and I'm here, like, that's my stand. It's like, you know what, but I'm cleaning, I'm doing something right. And then she saw like, yeah, I got your phone calls, and you know, I do want to apologize because that time that you called me, I was on the freeway, I couldn't really hear you, so my immediate thought was just like, you know, no. But Ben has actually told me really great things about you. He told me that you cleaned this place up. It looks fabulous. It looks wonderful. My father actually gave me this place when I was younger, and he gave me this place, and now I have it. I am planning to do construction, but I just wanted to thank you, you know, because you've been cleaning up and you've been keeping this place clean. And you know, I'm looking at it right now and actually very, very quite surprised that you did all this. And then I told her, I'm actually willing to, you know, if you let me and allow me to, I can, like, you know, offer you something. I can pay you on a monthly basis, whatever you want. If you just let me stay here. What I have been doing is I've been telling everyone that they can't be here because I cannot say anything about them because I cannot be cleaning up after them. But I can, you know, what I can do is I can clean up after myself and always make sure that this is super clean. And she's like, you know what, like, you have a business, you have to pay your own bills, I'm not looking to make any money off of you. And I was like, please let me contribute to you and let me offer you this, so you know that I really want to be good with you guys. She's all like, no, I cannot take that, but just to let you know, you can stay here exclusively only for you, as long as you do keep doing the good job that you're doing, keeping it clean. And as I was like, I wanted to scream. I was like, Oh, thank you so much. And I honestly, I wanted to cry at that moment, but I was just like so grateful. Like, thank you so much for allowing me to be here. I promise you, I'm gonna keep it clean. She's like, yeah, just don't let anyone be in this place, in this land, because like I said, I do want plan to do construction, but in the meantime, you can be here and then Ben can let you know when we're starting the construction, and then, you know, you are gonna have to move. I was like, you know, but that's gonna be take a while for right now. You know, it could take a while until that happens. And I was like, oh yes, no problem. Just let me know, and I'll be more than happy to, you know, to move to another place. Meanwhile, I'm gonna keep extremely clean, and I'll make sure that nobody, you know, stays here or puts their stand in here except, you know, myself. She's like, okay then. Well, it was nice meeting you, Erica, and yeah, you can stay here and. This is your business, right? I was like, yes, this is my business. It's actually a family business. And we just finished, so I mean, I was just picking up trash. And she was like, okay then, well, you know, we'll keep in touch. And I was like, okay, well, thank you so much. And yes, that's how we got the spot at Valley. Ooh, just telling the story is just, you know, it just kind of showed me that because they told you one time no doesn't mean that it's infinitive. It's a no, it's temporary, and it can be turned into a yes. So yeah, you know, I've been dealing with this whole time about corriendo todas las personas in a nice way. Obviously, I wish everyone could be there, but they exclusively told me that I can only be the one that could be there because they want, you know, someone who's responsible. And yeah, les estaba diciendo yo a todos que no pueden estar ahí, pues ya ni modo, you know. They're entrepreneurs, so I'm pretty sure those other businesses will find other places to be at. So yes, that's it. I'll see you guys next week because my battery's about to die. Bye.